Hi friends, welcome back to my channel and a very very good evening to us in this video. So since one of my friends have discussed, asked about or requested about future groups basically, and also to the large number of shareholders who are holding future groups must know what is really happening in the background of this future group, so called other informations. So lastly, when I finally spoke about future groups, I just discussed about what could be the reality of the valuation the people could get. Because the basic problem what was here is that all the business would get transferred into future enterprise in the apart from the ratios. And after that, nothing, no business will be left from future for future enterprise. And which means basically any other business which is left with other future enterprise would be carried on, and that is what we discussed. So basically we are going to see what are the recent developments apart from that. Okay, so what has basically happened, we know, right? I mean, after the deal was completed and all the things were going very very happily for both future retail groups as well as for Reliance Industries, there came Amazon. So Amazon filed a arbitration court case against what is so called this deal in Singapore, where they restrained from proceeding this deal, and that is really a good point in the point of view of Amazon. But it further deteriorated the share price of each and every shareholder of each and every future retail group. Okay, so let it be future retail, future consumer, future supply and logistics limited, future retail limited. I think many companies get drastically affected due to the so-called case news. So I'm going to just share this another bad news with you. So what has basically happened here is that the chief financial officer of this company. So what this is to inform you that the Dinesh Sharma Maheshwari has resigned from the executive director and the chief financial officer from the company as on 31st of December, who shall also continue to be a key major person. I think this is one of the so-called a bit of bad news for this company. Now going on to the next news is that this is another so-called court case. So after Amazon in the arbitration court case, Clicks Capital approaches court against future groups. I think this news came on I think December 31st or so. So what they are trying to say is that Clicks Capital has extended loan more than 90 crores to Future Capital Investment Private Limited against a pledge of shares of Future Retail Limited as well as Future Consumer Limited. The lending firm moved to the court seeking interim relief against the future group entities after a reduction in the aggrieved security cover cost with a fall in the share price of the pledged shares. Now what they are trying to say is that if these assets are going to sell, okay, if these assets are going to be sold to the various entities controlled by the billionaire Mukesh Ambani, so what will happen is that any alienation of the small property as a result of future group's career action will result in an injury to Clicks Capital, and this is being the security of the again loan extended to the future groups, the repayment is partly outstanding. So it is really, how to say, creating each and every problem has been generating day by day for this company. Okay, it all started from this arbitration court case from Amazon, then they moved to the Delhi High Court where they supported again this so-called fighting with the stock cases regarding stopping this kind of event processing away. And the next thing came, this the CFO resignated from this position, and this Clicks Capital. So all this bad news are going one side, but I just want to share you one happy news or a bit of news which could make the shareholders happy. So I just saw this news. I just want to give this news to you. Future groups firms receive large orders from Reliance. Okay, so this is really a very, very good thing. So future groups and future enterprise under the future groups have started receiving large orders from Reliance Industries Limited, according to the former chief executive officer Kishore Biyani. And this is a bit of good thing. So two new brands under this fashion and FMCG, and this is really a very, very good thing for future groups, because they are receiving, and this is came on January 22nd 2021. So this is really a very, very good thing, because they could get some bit of so called business from the other party. Now let us come to a point of realization here, because news comes every day, problems come temporary, but solution would be a permanent solution. So going with this side, if I buy now, whether could I get any benefit, if you ask me, friends, I think it is very, very, very difficult to decide what would be the potential, whether this merger would happen or whether this special purpose vehicle or so-called total buyout would happen. And that is the first place Competition Committee of India is approving. I mean, we have seen everything, but the court case is still pending in the Supreme, I mean, or so-called Singapore Arbitration Court case. So that is creating a bit of impact on the every share price of the shareholders. So as and when the good news comes, okay, as and when the, I mean, what are people doing right now is, as a trader, what people are doing is that whenever the share price going into lower, people are buying, and when the good news comes at the high price, when the market is at a good high price, people are exiting. And this is what happening day by day, the share price. On the same hand, the share price is also reducing day by day. Now what one could do actually, wait. I mean, if you have already entered, right? I think I already warned about entering at the price of around 160 rupees when we discussed about so-called what could be the real valuation of the shares, and also discuss about when these businesses are going away from Future Consumer Limited or Future Retail Limited, etc. It comes under a single point called Future Enterprise Limited. So all the businesses will be going from all the different subsidiaries of this company to Future Enterprise Limited. And from Future Enterprise Limited, this company will, business will go to the Reliance Industries and subsidiary groups. Okay, so it would be left with some bit of cash as well as some bit of so-called insurance business and a flight of business. Okay, and that is what the real valuation of Future Group would be if the deal is to be completed. So it is very, very difficult to predict what be the valuation. So let this all buyout company, let this first this court case let get completed, and then we see what could happen. If you have a belief that there would be the Supreme, I mean the so-called Supreme Court case which is going in the so-called Singapore would be positive for Reliance Industries, then you could definitely buy and keep it. I mean, instead of buying all these companies, you could definitely keep Future Enterprise Limited because all assets are transferring to that company. So think and decide carefully what you're going to do, because the price you are going to pay for each and every share is going to be very, very cleanly washed in the market momentum. Thank you, friends, and see the video very soon.